This is a piece of 1.5 inch schedule 40 pipe. I drew a line down each side and I go over to the bandsaw and I cut each end off at 7.5 degrees. The miter gauge is set at 7.5 degrees. I come in 1 centimeter or about 3/8 of an inch. I'm going to line that up with that saw blade and turn that until the two lines I've made on the pipe are parallel to the table. So I want to make a bunch of these. They're as close to being the same as possible. I just keep cutting this, turning this pipe back and forth until I have about 25 or 30 of these to play with. I'm going to glue this together later on, and that bandsaw cut is a little bit too rough for a good glue joint, so I'm going to sand that smooth on the belt sander. After you sand these, clean up these edges real good. We don't want any little pieces of plastic or anything to be interfering with our glue joint. I'm just using PVC pipe cement. Put it on both sides of the joint. Bring that together, rotate it back and forth a little bit. And then I'm just barely offsetting that joint. And set those down, let those dry for an hour or so. Make sure that glue is good and dry and that joint is good and hard. So now we're going to glue a couple of pairs together. And we continue our offset. Next, we will glue sections of 4 together, maintaining the same offset. When you butt glue all these segments together, it's surprisingly strong. You can squeeze on that, you can pull on it. It's not going anywhere. After my initial experimentation, I decided to speed this process up a little bit. I put a stop block on here. I still have the lines drawn on the pipe so I can flip it back and forth and know when those are approximately parallel to the table. Now these are all reasonably close to being the same. I still need to sand them to smooth that edge. And running this across the bandsaw, there'll be some variation. And when I sand this, there'll be some more variation. So I made up a little gauge block. I'm going to sand that and check them and make sure they all come into about the same point on the gauge block so that I know that they're all about the same size on the small end and that they're all pretty close to 15 degrees. I'm just deburring the edges inside and outside. We'll make it easier to glue these together later. I won't have any little pieces of plastic getting in the way. When you cut these on the bandsaw and then sand them on the belt sander, the actual center point of this segment can shift a little bit. So I use this jig again, and I find where the center of the narrow part of the segment is. I come over here, I look to see where it centers in the jig, and I mark the new center on the segment. With a little patience, perseverance, you can make a toroid. I had to adjust some of these wedges to get it to come out fairly round. It's not the prettiest toroid I've ever seen, but not too bad considering it's handmade out of a piece of plastic pipe. You can play with the angles, pipe diameter, the size of the wedges to make different sizes. Wrap that with a foil back tape, and I'd say that would be a good step towards making the Tesla coil. Or you can make a toroid spiral. I wasn't terribly proud of the first spiral I made, so I made a second one. And I'm always getting these flyers in the mail to vote for somebody or buy something or whatever. I throw these into a stack because they're very handy for making templates. And you just have to play with this, cut that out step by step until you get that to fit so that you can make a piece of wood that you can insert the spiral through, keeping in mind that you are going to have to maintain a flat plane through there. I have a piece of junk plywood. It's really nasty on the back side. Not sure where I got it. Nobody's going to see that side. I take my template, lay it on there, cut this out, and I made a piece that would inset, pick up and fill in the back side, added a piece over here, and I've drawn 7, 7 1/4, 7 1/2, and 8 inch diameter circles as a reference. I drilled a 1/2 inch hole so I can spin this on my circle sanding jig on the disc sander. And while that was centered on the drill press, I started drilling a 1 7/8 hole, which will just fit 1 1/2 inch piece of plastic pipe. And you're going to have to taper this with your sander on this side and on this side to match up with the curvature on that piece of pipe. My spiral fits down in here like this. The pipe will easily clear. And looking at this, I think I'm going to go with the 7-inch diameter circle. Actually, I've decided to go with the 7 1/4 inch diameter. This spiral is about 6 1/2 inches in diameter. Go in there like that. And a pipe will come up from the center. I'll put a clamp on there. I'm going to put construction adhesive all the way around this to hold it in place. That'll take a couple of days to dry. I'll leave that clamped up, work on something else for a while.